It's been a busy few weeks on the GT50 programme. Here's a quick update on the main areas of focus that we've been working on. As you're aware, we've been going to great lengths to master the processes for casting superalloy turbine blades in-house from end to end, every stage of the process. Over the last few weeks, the team have been over to Germany to conduct the factory acceptance test on the specific equipment that we're purchasing to be able to make these blades in-house. The test was successful. We've proven to the extent necessary the machine and the plant will do what we want it to. Within the next 2 weeks, we're expecting to receive delivery of the main vacuum furnace that we'll be using to actually pour the molten superalloy into the blade molds. And what we're doing at the moment is starting to develop the whole casting cell infrastructure here at PC1 ready to carry out that process. Let's go and have a look at some of the other facilities we've been developing. In the previous AMA, I showed you the little lab scale furnace that we'd bought to enable us to rapidly develop the casting processes for individual compressor turbine and power turbine blades. That enabled us to conduct the factory acceptance tests over in Germany to prove that the vacuum casting machine that we need to actually pour metal into the molds was going to be suitable for our application. That was successfully completed. So of course, we've now been able to procure the full-size furnace, the big brother of the one that we showed you previously. And this machine will allow us to heat the molds that we need to pour the superalloy liquid metal into the molds that form the blades to the crazy temperatures that are required to do that. This machine is able to keep up with the production volumes that we require and forms an instrumental part of the new casting facility that's going right in next to the composites facility over there in PC1. So while that facility is being commissioned and we're getting into the position where we can repeatably cast those blades in-house, we're currently machining blades from a slightly different alloy to allow us to conduct the early stages of the GT50 testing without having to wait for this stuff. Let's go and have a look at the blade machining down in the machine shop. In order to accelerate the development of the GT50 engine and get it on the test bench as soon as we can, in parallel with the critical casting processes that we're developing to keep the cost under control in production, we're also able to machine the turbine blades from a slightly different alloy to allow us to make changes to the blades as required and machine them without needing any of the infrastructure that you need to cast blades. So over the course of the last couple of weeks, the guys have been developing the process to be able to machine superalloy blades from solid, and then they'll go off and have their fir tree roots ground as we would for the cast blades. And this allows us to get the test engine running as quickly as possible while we go over the final few details of the production process we need to make these things much more cost effectively in series production. While we're able to cast the turbine blades for the GT50 engine in production, one component that you always have to machine is the centrifugal impeller. The centrifugal impeller on the front of GT50 requires an extremely high grade titanium, which is incredibly difficult to machine quickly. What we're doing at the moment is finalizing the production process for casting the impeller and getting the cycle times down to the absolute minimum that we can while hitting all of the geometrical tolerances and surface finish requirements we need to make these things both cost effectively with absolutely A-grade performance. This is the first of the latest generation centrifugal impellers that we're developing to test on the first running GT50 engine.